wherever you are around the world, and thank you for your company. It is time for another Spiritual Baby Speed Study on Truth to You. That's truth2u.org. G'day, Mr. Spiritual Babies.
G'day, Jono. Good morning, everyone.
Guess what, Mr. Spiritual Babies? I am wearing my Spiritual Baby Zizi. They are so great, and I really like them. The quality is awesome, and I'm so glad that I bought some Zizi from you. Boy, they came quickly, and the boys are wearing theirs as well. They're very, very proud. They're wearing them everywhere, and I just want to let everybody know that they can purchase ZZ from Spiritual Babies by going to spiritualbabies.net. In fact, I'll put a link. You can even put a little link on the video here, right?
Yeah, we can do that.
There it is. Go and get some Spiritual Babies ZZ because they're really, really good.
Oh, thanks very much. And it's so nice to know that your boys are wearing them.
They love them. They love them.
Like we're going to explore later on. You teach it to your children.
Amen. Are we going to try and do this in 20 minutes again?
We're going to try.
What are we looking at?
We are looking actually in the book of Psalms, and we're looking at the instances where Torah is used.
Torah?
The word Torah.
Torah in the Psalms. What is the Strong's number?
The word Torah is Strong's number 8451, Torah. And it's actually, it turns up a lot in the whole Tanakh, and I'd recommend anyone just go in and pick a book and have a look at the instances the word comes up.
Mm.
It's translated into tons of different things all through the Bible. Lots of different, from teaching and ruling and instruction and custom. But in the Psalms, it usually comes up as law or instruction.
It does. So where's the first place that we see it?
It is in Psalms 1-2.
Give me 1-3. Give me 1-3.
Yeah, sure.
Psalm chapter 1, verses 1-3. What does it say?
Happy is the man who has not followed the counsel of the wicked or taken the path of sinners. Or joined the company of the insolent. Rather, the teaching of Jehovah is his delight. That's your first one, teaching.
Yeah.
And he studies that teaching day and night. He is like a tree planted beside streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, whose foliage never fades, and whatever it produces thrives.
Oh, nice. And on his Torah, he meditates day and night. Do you know what that always... It always reminds me, Mr. Spiritual Babies, of... Christians that I've known over the years that would go on about how we should meditate on God's law, must always meditate on God's law. And I used to think, what does that mean to them? I don't understand. How can they tell me that and then go and have, a ham sandwich? And I thought, the conclusion that I came to is that they must go home, sit cross-legged and go, law. I don't know, but... Whatever it was, we obviously had two different ideas. The second one, the second time it comes up, Psalm 19, verse 7. I love this one, Mr. Spiritual Babies, because this is what it says. The Torah of Jehovah is almost perfect, converting
almost.
The soul. Oh, sorry. No, it doesn't say almost perfect. Oh, my mistake. No, it says the Torah of Jehovah is perfect, converting the soul. It's perfect. What does that mean?
What it says. It's perfect.
It can't mean what it says. Don't be silly. We can't tell the people that.
Or maybe we should stick with almost perfect.
That's better. That's much better. The Torah of Jehovah is almost perfect, converting the soul. Now, look, how much clearer can it be? The Torah of Jehovah is perfect. It's complete. It is entirely whole. It is absolutely perfect. The first five books of the Tanakh, the Torah, it is perfect, converting the soul. Converting? Turning back the soul, returning the soul. If I had to paraphrase, could I say causing the soul to repent? Could I say that?
And we know from the Tanakh that if you turn to him, he turns to you. He forgets your sin and woo, you're back on track. Awesome.
It's perfect at doing that. You know that?
Yeah. Oh, man, the best rocks.
Don't fix it if it's not broken. Okay. Psalm 37, 29 to 31. What do you got?
The righteous will inherit the land and dwell in it forever. The mouths of the righteous utter wisdom, and their tongues speak what is just. The law of their God is in their hearts. Their feet do not slip.
There you go. The Torah of his God is in his heart. Psalm 40, verse 6 and 8. We've done this before, Mr. Spiritual Babies. I'm getting deja vu. What does it mean?
All right. 6 and 8. Sacrifice and offering you did not desire, but my ears you have opened. Burnt offerings and sin offerings you did not require. Then I said, Here I am, I have come. It is written about me in the scroll. I desire to do your will, my God. Your Torah is written within my heart.
Your Torah is written within my heart. Now, now we've already done this. We have, haven't we? Now, we did this when we talked about Hebrews chapter 10. What was that called? Which one was that?
It was called Body Snatchers.
It was. Body Snatchers. And you can click on it now on the screen, right? You're going to do a bit of that?
Oh, yeah. It's going to be some internet magic.
It's on this. Okay. So, but just really quickly, I'm going to read what it says in Hebrews. It says, therefore, when he came into the world, he said, sacrifice and offering you did not desire, a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sacrifices for sin, you had no pleasure. Then I said, behold, I have come. In the volume of the book, it is written of me to do your will, O God. Now it goes on to, now finishes there, Mr. Spiritual Babies, in the book of Hebrews. It conveniently finishes there. Do you know what it says after that?
What does it say?
In verse 8, it says, previously saying, sacrifice and offering, burnt offerings and offerings for sin you did not desire, nor had pleasure in them, but which are offered according to the law.
Mm.
Then he said, behold, I have come to do your will, O God. He takes away the first, that he may establish the second. Takes away the first so he can establish the second. But what does it continue to say in Psalm chapter 40, verse 8?
Verse 8 says, I desire to do your will, my God. Your law is written within my heart.
He doesn't take away the first to replace it with the second. He doesn't do any of that. The Torah is within my heart is what it says in the Psalms. Lovely. Psalm 78, verse 1, a contemplation of Asaph. He says, give ear, O my people, to my Torah. And he goes on. He in Psalm 78, verses 5 through to 10, it says, he established a testimony in Jacob and appointed a Torah in Israel. Now we're talking about the first five books, which he commanded our fathers to teach their children, that the next generation might know them, the children yet unborn, and arise and tell them to their children, so that they should set their hope in God and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments, and that they should not be like their fathers, stubborn, rebellious generation, a generation whose heart was not steadfast, whose spirit was not faithful to God. The Ephraimites, armed with the bow, turned back on the day of battle. They did not keep God's covenant, but refused to walk according to his Torah. And the thing I really like about this is, Mr. Spiritual Babies, is that it says you keep the Torah so that you can teach your children, so that they can teach their children, so that they should set their hope in God and not forget the works of God, but keep his commandments.
Right. 78 in itself is a fantastic kind of synopsis of the story of Israel. And it's very interesting that for as much as it mentions the Torah and his people remembering the Torah, it also highlights what happens when you don't.
So the next one is Psalm 89. Now, I've got verses 16 to 38. Do I really want to read all of that? That's apparently what I want to do. It's so I've told myself in my notes. This is what it says.
Okay,
in your name. I'm going to have to read it because I've told myself to do that in the notes. Okay. Read from – oh, no, it says read from the new JPS. Ooh, hold on 1 second. All right, the next one is Psalm 89. I am going to read from verse 16 to 38. You ready for this?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not. Where is it? Here it is. Okay. Here we go. Here we go. Happy is the people who know the joyful shout, O Yehovah. They walk in the light of your presence. They rejoice in your name all day long. They are exalted through your righteousness, for you are their strength in which they glory. Our horn is exalted through your favor. Truly, our shield is of Yehovah, our King, the Holy One of Israel. Then you spoke to your faithful ones in a vision and said, I have conferred power upon a warrior. I have exalted one chosen out of the people. I have found David, my servant, anointed him with my sacred oil, and my hand shall be constantly with him, and my arm shall strengthen him. No enemy shall oppress him, no vile man afflict him. I will crush his adversaries before him. I will strike down those who hate him. My faithfulness is steadfast, and steadfast love shall be with him. His horn shall be exalted through my name. I will set his hand upon the sea, his right hand upon the rivers. He shall say to me, you are my Father, my God, the rock of my deliverance. Oh, how cool is that?
Yeah, it's very cool.
That's verse 27. He shall say to me, you are my Father, my God, the rock of my deliverance. I will appoint him firstborn, highest of the kings of the earth. I will maintain my steadfast love for him always. My covenant with him shall endure. I will establish his line forever. His throne as long as the heavens last, if his sons forsake my teaching and do not live by my rules, if they violate my laws, if they do not observe my commandments, I will punish their transgression with the rod, their iniquity with plagues, but I will not take away my steadfast love from him. I will not betray my faithfulness. I will not violate my covenant or change what I have uttered. I have sworn by my holiness once and for all. I will not be false to David. His line shall continue forever, his throne as the sun before me, as the moon established forever, an enduring witness in the sky. How good is it?
It's epic.
Is epic, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is. The pictures that are in there are epic. And it reminds me a lot of, I know we covered one of the Hebrew Roots videos we've done already, but the Deleting Heaven and Earth one covers a lot of the same topics.
If you click on the screen now.
Yep, they'll be there.
You'll do that. And then, now, of course, that reminds me, and I'm going to go there, and it is 2 Samuel chapter 7, of course. It reminds me a little bit of that because it does say, in regards to David's son, and that, of course, is Solomon we're talking about here. This is from verse 12. When your days are fulfilled and you rest with your fathers, I will set up your seed after you who will come from your body, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I will be his father, and he shall be my son. If he commits iniquity, I will chasten him with the rod of men, with blows of the sons of men. But my mercy shall not depart from him, as I took it from Saul, whom I removed from before you. And your house and your kingdom shall be established forever before you. Your throne shall be established forever. How good is that? And that's in regards to the Davidic kingship from David through Solomon.
There's so much in there as well. I mean, as you were reading that out, I was saying to myself, oh, look, David was anointed, and that made me think, well, David was, a Messiah. And it says he's his firstborn, and he's an everlasting king, because the kingship is always going to come through him. Mm-hmm. And the way he... the way David responds to Jehovah as his shield and as his king and as his heavenly father, I just think that's just it's fantastic.
Oh, it is. It's such
what a great example.
Great psalm. And hidden within is the word Torah, and that was in, which verse was that in? Oh, 89 verse 30. If his sons forsake my Torah and do not walk in my judgments. The next one, Psalm 94 verse 12. What do you got?
I'm going to read it from this one from the Holman. Jehovah, happy is the man you discipline and teach from your Torah to give him relief from troubled times until a pit is dug for the wicked. Jehovah will not forsake his people or abandon his heritage, for justice will again be righteous and all the upright in heart will follow it.
Oh, how good. So that was Psalm 94, verses 12 through to 15. Psalm 105, 42 to 45, what do you got?
For he remembered his holy promise given to his servant Abraham. He brought out his people with rejoicing, his chosen ones with shouts of joy. He gave them the lands of the nations, and they fell heir to what others had toiled for, that they might keep his precepts and observe his laws. Praise Jehovah.
That they might keep his statutes and observe his Torahs. Now, Torahs in the plural. There we go. Praise Jehovah.
Well, yeah, it's kind of funny. We look at the first five books as the Torah, but there's a lot of different Torahs in it.
A lot of instruction in there.
Right.
So now listen, now we're knocking on the door of Psalm 119. Is this not the crown jewel of, I mean, when you talk about the Torah, you cannot talk about it long without coming back to Psalm 119, which really is, I mean, the entire chapter is about the commandments and instructions of Jehovah. I am thinking that there's 25 verses, or at least I don't know if it's 25 verses, but it mentions the Torah in Psalm 119 25 times.
Yeah, directly. I think the whole thing is really a love letter to the Torah. Directly mentioning it 25 times.
All right, well, what we'll do, let's go through this as one continual psalm, if we can. These are all the verses that contain the word Torah. You can put up on the screen the verse that it is as we're reading. It begins with verse 1, and it says, how blessed are those whose way is blameless, who walk in the Torah of Yehovah.
Open thou mine eyes, that I may behold the wondrous things of thy law.
Ah, see, the listeners will know that one because that's the one we would read every week on Torah Pearls. The next one, remove the false way from me and graciously grant me your Torah.
Give me understanding and I shall keep your Torah, yea, I shall observe it with my whole heart.
So I will keep your Torah continually forever and ever.
The proud have me greatly in derision, yet I have not declined from your Torah.
Burning indignation has seized me because of the wicked who forsake your Torah.
I have remembered your name, O Yehovah, in the night, and have kept your Torah.
The cords of the wicked have encircled me, but I have not forgotten your Torah.
Their heart is as fat as grease, but I delight in your law.
That's one of the weirdest verses I've read for a while.
Right. What have you got in yours for that one?
Okay, so mine says, in the New King James at least, it says, their heart is as fat as grease, but I delight in your law. That's what it says.
So the JPS says, their minds are as thick as fat. As mines. For me, minds, right. So there's when we read in the English heart, we can almost always put mind in its place because people talk about the Hebrew concept and the Hebrew meaning. Well, generally speaking, if you see heart, unless you're eating one, if you see the word heart and it's a kind of a feeling, then you can replace it with mind. Mm-hmm. So their minds are thick like fat. As for me, your teachings is my delight. That must be Torah's.
That's Torah, but I delight in your Torah. The Torah of your mouth is better to me than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Let thy tender mercies come unto me that I may live, for thy Torah is my delight.
The arrogant have dug pits for me, men who are not in accord with your Torah.
Unless thy Torah had been my delight, I should have perished in my affliction.
Oh, how I love your Torah. It is my meditation all day long.
My soul is continually in my hands, yet I do not forget your Torah.
I hate those who are double-minded, but I love your Torah.
It is time for thee, Yehovah, to work, for they have made void thy Torah.
My eyes shed streams of water because they do not keep your Torah.
Thy righteousness is everlasting righteousness, and thy Torah is the truth.
Amen. Those who follow after wickedness draw near, they are far from your Torah.
Consider my affliction and deliver me, for I do not forget your Torah.
Wow. I hate and despise falsehood, but I love your Torah. That's the second time he's used hate. We're going to have to do hate in the Psalms. We'll get back to that.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, this will have a part two. Great peace have they which love your Torah, and nothing shall offend them.
Amen. I long for your salvation, O Yehovah, and your Torah is my delight.
Oh, that's great. Man, those are brilliant.
That is brilliant, isn't it? Do you know what? That reminds me of Jacob said that in Genesis 49. It was in 49 verse 18. I have waited for your salvation, O Yehovah. And here's David saying, I long for your salvation, O Yehovah, and your Torah is my delight. Awesome.
Awesome. That is awesome.
How many times?
They work together so well.
They do. They roll together really nicely. How many times did we go through, how many times does the word Torah appear in the Psalms?
Isn't it, I think it's 25 in Psalm 119 alone. I think it's something like 37.
Yeah, something like that. So there they are. That is all the occurrences of Torah in the Psalms. Any other comments, Mr. Spiritual Babies?
Yeah, absolutely. We can see most of these Psalms were written by David. He was the firstborn of Jehovah, his anointed Messiah and the King. And when the Torah does stream forth from Zion, all of these verses are going to be common knowledge to everybody.
They'll be sung.
They'll be sung. So we should get to know these as well as we can now and take the example of David and use this perfect Torah to help us return to Jehovah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Mr. Spiritual Babies at spiritualbabies.net.
Thanks for listening, everyone. You've been listening to truthtoyou.org. You can visit me on Facebook with Spiritual Babies and spiritualbabies.net. And you can come to Truth to You and on truthtoyou.org and find loads of other great programs, including the ever-popular Torah Pearls. and a program with Keith Johnson about the Israel and archaeology, and we've got some great stuff with Yoel Ben Shlomo and same as Aaron Michelson and loads of stuff. Thank you very much. Speak to you again next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.